Hello, and welcome. I'm Zeinder, and you might see it out of the corner of the screen. I got one! And I've also got an extra ender pearl. I made a void chest, and it wasn't working as simply as I wanted, but... Obsidian around an ender pearl. Pretty simple. It's from Railcraft, it just destroys items. I had to set up another... basic logistics pipes programmed for... oxygen, though, in order to make it work. And I just sent a good bit of wood through the processing system. This was not working, so I actually trashed all the axes that were already made, because I didn't really care. And I put down a capacitor bank, so it's more or less a buffer block. Actually, can I... limit you to 15. Yeah. I'm gonna put a limit on you. So this guy should actually start gaining power at some point. I took one of the engines I had running on the finished quarry and sat it down. If I limit him like that, that means that this guy's gonna end up absorbing most of the power, which I guess is okay for now. So, I've got this running. I have this inserting on green and extracting on brown. This is inserting on brown, and this is inserting on brown, but it's also extracting on brown. And then this is extracting on blue. This is inserting on blue and extracting on green. And this is inserting on green. So green will go here and here. That will extract into brown, which will go here, here, and then out of here, back into here, and then this will extract on blue and go back up into there. So it'll only make axes as it needs to. These will, of course, stockpile up on resources, not really anything to do. I say that, but this isn't as stockpiled as I expected. Weird. You are inserting on brown, and you are extracting on brown, so whatever. And then... oh, this actually doesn't need to be here. I've never removed this. There. What? Okay. I'll be back in a minute. Actually, what does this say? Concurrent modification exception. Weird. I'll be back. Okay. We are back. Hopefully we do not crash again. Just captured a zombie real quick while I was thinking of it. This is probably going to be an important thing. So, I did make some item conduits, which is pulsating iron nuggets, blah blah blah, around, you know, and I made some more power cables. We got those. And, whoo, look at that tree disappear. And it's so much better than the MFR tree farm, because it doesn't annihilate your frame rate to cut down a tree, which always annoyed me about MFR. So we are not generating power right now, actually. Well, we are, but we're not. As much as I hate to have an uneven amount. Okay, so we can now make the soul binder. Which is an Enderman head, basically one of each head. So one. Okay, one. Oh, poor Enderman head. Oh, poor Solarium. Not even remotely prepared on that front. Okay. And then I need to once again make another one of these stupid things. Oh, and I'm going to have to make some iron bars, because I used them all. I just thought of that right now, this very second. And no surprise that the solarium isn't done. And here comes the daytime. Now, I want to make this for two reasons. One, I found another blaze spawner and I broke it in order to get a blaze spawner type. We're actually going to change that. That's what the soul binder is for. Not that I can actually make a powered spawner, I don't think. I'm going to need another Ender Pearl, and then I'm going to need to make another Z-Logic controller. This is simple. But I need another Ender Pearl, so that's not going to happen. Not this episode. Probably next episode? Possibly. Right. We are still waiting on one more ingot. But, back to the Soulbinder. So. Bye. Yeah, I figured it wasn't gonna do anything unless I had all the materials. It still might, because heads. Oh, no, it worked. So. It says used to convert a spawner type, but it's actually used in a couple other things. One of those other things. Give me 10 levels. One of those other things being that if I take this and the zombie soul I just acquired. Oh, come on. I'm pretty sure it's made in here. Don't lie to me. Frankenzombie, Ender Crystal, Enticing Crystal. Oh, it's not a zombie. It's a villager. Why did I think it was a zombie? Oh, I didn't think it was. Okay, I know. I know what I did now. I should have actually kept that zombie. Just putting that out there. Is this going to cost 10 levels, or is this going to be super expensive? 15. Okay. As long as there's 10 levels left in there, that's all that really matters. So, this is going to take a while, and it's going to completely nuke my power supply. Right, I'm not going to get that back till the end. I'm going to go get a villager right now. I'm just going to select the villager with the worst possible trade. So, that's my plan there. And eventually, I'm going to come up with a much better food source, which is to say, a food source different than effectively nothing. Raw chicken. I'm taking you, because the other guy's raw chicken deal is better. So I can use the enticing crystal, although I don't have that yet. Egg. Nothing. Oops. Use the enticing crystal to make an attractor obelisk, which then I can put soul vials in to attract certain mobs. And it's actually got a decently low power cost right away. And I don't really need to go too far. It doesn't need a huge range, so I don't really need to upgrade it. Because the zombies already swarm for me. It's just a matter of then swarming them into a place that's better for me. If that makes any sense. Now, as far as I've been able to establish, the easiest way to describe the way that the attractor obelisk works is it simulates hitting the entity. So it makes it angry. Which, zombies have a tendency to, once they're angry with something, they will try to destroy it. Destroy all humans. And how far are we going? Oh, good. Okay. That's unpleasant. What can we do about that? If I take that out, that's not going to do me very good. This is going to take a very long time. It's still working. I didn't lose my progress. It's just takes a lot of power to do this. And unfortunately, we've got power sort of flowing everywhere. You know what? We don't need the tree farm at the moment. I'll put it here, so I don't forget about it. But we don't need the tree farm right now, because it's got more than enough of everything it needs. Yeah. There's plenty of wood in there, and I'm not in any major concern for methyl methacrylate right now. But, I just wanted to make sure. Yeah, see, I got plenty. I wanted to make sure that I had a way to automate that right away. A lot of this is probably going to get moved. I haven't figured out whether I'm going to put it on that side or that side of the citadel, but. I don't know. Take this. What I do know is that this needs to hurry up. In case we don't get there, it's really simple. It's actually the exact same recipe as this, only it's got an enticing crystal and energetic alloys. So, stupid simple. What is the other thing? I suppose I should probably try to get work on power creation, but I haven't really left myself in a good place for that. Is that going to be enough? That should be enough. Oh, I'm not going to have the diamonds to work with that. Steam. Actually, do I want to make the steam yet? I want to make a reservoir, actually. If I'm going to do anything related to steam, I need a reservoir. So, 8? I think? Probably? Yes. 6 glass. Actually, no, I need to do this twice. So, I need another 8 more, actually. I forgot. So, I'm going to need 2 cauldrons. I did not want to throw my blocks of iron on the floor. 2 cauldrons. Boom. Condensed into a block. And would you hurry up, please? I'm rather impatient, and I don't like waiting for you. And we're like 20% of the way there. Fun. Okay, so reservoirs are fun. So long as they have 2 buckets worth of water in them, they will run. Also, I want to try something. I don't know if this is going to work. Like, I seriously don't know at all. But we'll see. First of all, I'm going to want to make some pipes. Probably unnecessary, but to do it this way, but I don't care. Okay, so I need a furnace. I actually have no idea how much power this thing can, or how much, what the amount per tick this will make is, but whatever it is, I'm going to try to live with it for the moment. If I put you here, good, good, you face the right way. I haven't actually been using this. Move that out of the way. Don't even want it in my inventory at the moment. So, I need another bucket of water. Totally didn't just bust through my wall. Now, if I wrench this, see that little arrow? That means it's auto-outputting. Which is good, because we're going to put this down. And it's going to auto-output a bucket every couple ticks, something like that. I was worried about that. Will it work? Oh, I don't have any way of making a fluid. I do have a way, but I don't at the same time. Excuse me, I would like some more gravel. Replace it with dirt. I need to make more conduit binder. Clay, clay, clay. I have excess clay, don't I? Guess not. Oh, I need sand too, don't I? Ooh, I have some sand. Good. Binder. Composite. Very good. I'm gonna need you in furnace mode, actually. Oh, be quiet. And three glass. This is gonna give it a sort of. It's gonna make it. What's the word I'm looking for? Gravity bound. But that's okay. No? Fluid conduit. Oh, quite clear glass. Are you serious? Let me guess. The only way to make it is in that machine. With it on alloys mode. How inconvenient. This should make it two at a time. Yes. I go a little bit slower, but that's okay. I can live with that. How are you guys doing? You're doing, I suppose. What are you doing? You're at half. It may or may not be finished by the time we're done. Okay. 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 And fluid conduit. I don't know if this is going to work. So I want you to extract auto off if I provide you with. You know what? We'll just start with sulfur. Start with this bit of sulfur. Will you run? Will you extract steam? You will not. I was worried about that. Oh, don't be this way. Oops. Pool. That's pretty much the problem with this mod. For some odd reason, its steam is incompatible. There is something, a part of this mod. I'm wondering. Pressure converter. Do I have enough to make this? I do? As long as I have. I've got leather. I've got a pane of glass. I've got pipes. I don't know if this is what I'm looking for, but I think it is. This should hopefully do the job I'm looking for. It looks like it is, it's just a matter of placement now. Okay. Two pipes. I like you and all, but you're causing me difficulties. Could you please vacate the premises? That's enough. That's vacated enough. It's gonna give me a hard time. For some reason, not entirely unexpected. No. There. Okay. So, let's try this again. If I put... No, that's actually not going to work. If I put this here, and I put this here, and I put this here, why are you not extracting? Oh, that's not what I meant to do. Please tell me if I put this back in, it's going to fix itself. Okay. Is it still auto-pushing? It was not, but it is now. Okay, pick you up. Oh. Really? Really? Broke it. Okay, we're gonna turn this guy sideways then. Like that. And then we'll do one of these. And I unfortunately need a new bucket of water. Ow. Stop. It hurts. Mostly. I win. Okay. So, you know what? It's nighttime, it's raining. We'll just sleep it away. Okay, so, place in bucket of water. Activate auto out. Refill bucket of water. So now, theoretically, this right here is actually not necessary, but I'm doing it for... Why did I do that? Because I can, more or less. No. Okay. Now, if I fuel you... Okay. Why is this not functioning? Can it only connect on the top? It should be throwing steam out the top right now. What? What is going on here? Do I have, like, the... a defective mod or something? Like, what's going on? Oh! Finally! Holy crap! Now, I just need to power it somehow. Ow. Okay. Okay, I want to try something then. If that works... Does this work? Yes, yes, you're filled with steam, so you're considering yourselves two different connections. I understand. Extract. Okay, very good. And where am I going to put this lever that it won't interfere with everything? I haven't really left a good place for that, have I? Well, I can take these out. You, always active. Okay, very good. So I should be able to put this here and then it won't interfere. Right? The question is, how fast are you generating steam? I might be burning steam faster than it's being generated. Oh, no. We'll see. The reason I did this is because it's quite literally just 20 RF a tick I don't have otherwise, so there's really no reason not to. And I didn't realize all those machines ran out of power, so that kind of ground that to a halt. That is full. So that literally means that this machine alone is eating all of the power I'm generating. So if I'm understanding this right, this machine is capable of 10 millibuckets per tick. And let's see, 20 ticks in a second, so 15 seconds? Theoretically, for these, you would think if it's running at a normal speed, but I don't know. It's more or less designed to be a supplemental power source at this point. I'm actually quite happy about the fact that I can translate pressure. Does it work the other way? Can I translate pressure back into the mod with this? Or will its machines just naturally accept other types of steam? That is a question. But this is one of the cool things that I wanted from this. It basically, I can put it on top of an anvil, and then I can basically perform anvil-related experience functions using steam. Oh, hurry up. I don't think it's going to be done, guys. Don't think it's going to be done before everything is over. Although I guess technically it's over when I declare it's over, so this does heat up a lot faster. Like, this doesn't heat up, but the amount of RF in it heats up. So it should start kicking out power at a decent rate soon. This takes more power per tick, but thankfully the age of machines that reset progress whenever you run out of power has been pretty much phased out, apparently. So there is that. But I'd really like to make a soul binder, so not a soul binder, I already have a soul binder. Do I want to make a powered spawner? Well, no, not this time. But I do want to make an attractor obelisk. So I have things to cook, apparently. Just gonna slow this process down, but what can you do? Alloy mode, very good. Oh. That's a problem. That's not a problem, that's hilarious. I need to process some gold. ASAP. Because I'm out. The supply of gold I have is now empty. 19 gold ore there, 6 there. That means there's a full stack in here somewhere. Come on. I haven't taken the gold out here, and I know that there's not only a stack of 6. I'm probably missing it. There's the iron. I know there's gold in here somewhere. I don't understand what's going on right now. Where's the gold? It could be there's just so much crap in here that I'm not actually cycling through to the gold at all. Whoops. Screw it. 25 gold ore will have to do. Now I think about it, there's a possibility that is actually all the gold. Seems like a low amount, though. Question is, do I process it using... I'm gonna triple it. Corso, if I go to do that, one of the first things I need to do is make sure that... Yeah, that's a problem. There's no methyl. There is hydrogen and carbon, though, so I'll take one of each of those out. I'll bust that apart. You will process this. Now, the default route is, of course, here. And gold. Why you gotta make gold powder? That's just rude. At least it will conveniently craft them for me as I put them in. Although this is a massive power drain. Look at that. I'm pretty sure this guy's taking up most of the power right now. Well, him and the Soulbinder are both very, very massive power drains. Okay, well, I guess I'll have to take the pulverized gold I've gotten so far, set this to furnace, and start cooking. And then I'll worry about the rest of this later. How about you, Soulbinder? How are you doing? Almost done. Very good. I'm sure this process isn't helping that matter at all, but... Oh, crap. I just realized I am going to need another piece of gold. Eh, it can wait. So, I'm going to need... One. Yeah, because I'm going to need gold nuggets. If you could hurry this process up, please. Once this finishes, everything should get a lot better. That's the theory. Man, look at this thing cruising along. It almost worries you that it's going to explode. But I believe in it. Okay, so furnace, gold. Hurry up. I'm impatient. You're done. Okay. You've made more pulverized gold, okay. You're waiting to make more. As soon as I give you the ability. Okay. Soulbinder's nearly done. We're going over what I'd like to be over for a segment, but not a whole lot I can do right now. Machine chassis, go. Bam. Oh, forgot the iron bars. Bam. Tank, I don't need you. Remaining iron, I do not need you. Fluid pipe, regular pipes, don't need you. Brass, don't need you. Bam. Why do I have clay? Oh, because I had extra clay from the thing. Yeah. I'm assuming. You done? You're done! Okay, good. Take this and this. And 10 levels. So, an enticing crystal only takes 100,000 RF, so basically, once it dumps the machine buffer, it's done. Oh, come on. Don't be this way. Where's a zombie? You're not a zombie. Hey, could you one of you zombies come here in range, please? Thank you. Enticing crystal. Everything is done, right? I think I have everything. Tractor obelisk. Draws mobs towards it. Specify the mobs to affect by placing their souls within the device. So basically, the rest of this is going to be stupid simple. I'll do a quick Enderman check. This is kind of drying out, but I'm gonna live with it. It's okay to have one really excessively long episode occasionally, right? So, the plan. The plan. Take some dirt. The plan. The plan. Ah, screw it. I don't care about the stone. I'll use some of it for this process. Oh, come on. Why is it not jump back? Jump. So, the plan is I'm going to make a small hill. I'm thinking 7 by 7, actually. 7 by 7. How far have I gone? 6, 7. Could you please stay dead and leave me alone? So, way this is going to work is, first of all, I'm going to do one of these. Okay. And then here and here, in theory. Then, for cosmetic sake, put some dirt around the outside. Stupid strawberries. Technically, the lower layer of dirt does not need to be here, but I've decided it needs to be, so it is. So then, right here in the center, there will be the attractor obelisk. And in this obelisk, we're going to place our zombie soul. Okay? It is a range of 16 blocks, which shouldn't be an issue, actually. And then around this, and it'll be coming through here. Okay. And like that. Like this. There. There. And technically, I'm gonna want something that can block that. I don't have anything on me, but I'll worry about that at some other point. So. Oh, wow. I can't believe how perfectly that worked out. Now the question is, what is the safest way to get a form of power over here? I'm gonna be honest. The safest way is to just put a power source over here. Okay, so carbon, hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. There, I've set that back up. That is good. All I need to do is power this, and then I'm actually going to put a roof over. Three by three section. So this should prevent them from burning. They'll come in, they'll get stuck, they'll fall down the hole, and then they'll be stuck down there, and it's basically an experience farm. I will have to come out here and power this once night rolls around, but I'm not worried about that. A little steam engine that could. So I'm gonna call this good. Gone on longer than intended, about 41 minutes. Things kind of got slightly upset by the crash, but that's okay. And just checking the power. Yep, I'm gonna call this good, and I will see you guys next time. Have a good day!